Simple Swing Thoughts, guys. Simple Swing Thoughts YouTube channel right here in my house. Now, a lot of people ask me, why aren't I on the golf course? And I say, well, number one, it's been the rainy season down here in the Caribbean. But number two, everybody's in the house. Okay, everybody in the United States, everybody in the UK, Canada, everybody's confined to the house. So why shouldn't I be confined to the house? So that's why I do these videos from the house, because guys, this is where you learn how to swing the club. This is where you learn how to position your body so you can use this golf club effectively. Now, I'm going to talk about the shoulder unit. Okay, now if I were to ask you a question, guys, what body part, which major body part actually dictates your swing plane? Which body part actually influences your swing plane? Okay, is it your feet? Is it your hips? Is it your shoulders? Is it your head? Which one would you guess? Well, if you guess the shoulders, or if you know it's the shoulders, you'd be right. Okay, because guys, what happens is when we grip the club properly, okay, here at 2-6, we grip the club properly, okay, and we got the nice athletic stance. What happens is, guys, because we've gripped the club, and this isn't any grip, okay, this isn't every grip, okay, this isn't all the grips, this is nothing special. You obviously grab the club with the trail hand below the lead hand. And so when you do that, that automatically sets the what? Trail shoulder below the lead shoulder. Okay, but what we have to understand, guys, is if we have a leveraged grip, which is what we teach here at 2-6, it's not a strong grip, it's a leveraged grip. Okay, what happens is when you set the club down, that actually puts your trail shoulder about an inch lower than your lead shoulder if you were to just grip the club traditionally. If you just grip the club, you know, how everybody's been taught, okay, you would grip the club at 2-6. The leverage grip would actually put your trail shoulder about an inch below your lead shoulder. So automatically right there, you're in a better position with that particular, with this particular grip, if you were to grip the club 2-6 with the 2-6 leverage grip. So what happens is, because we have the right grip and our trail shoulder begins below our lead shoulder, guys, what happens is we don't need to start manipulating our club. Okay, now what do I mean by that? Guys, when we're over the ball, we don't want to start lifting the club or fanning the club open or trying to get the toe up too soon, because what that would do, guys, that would yank our club to the inside, okay, and then it would actually pull our shoulders off the plane. Because you see, what happens is when our shoulders are set, and this is the down the line view. When our shoulders are set, we want to make sure that we what? That we take the club away with our shoulder unit directly on the plane. Which means what? It simply means that if our hands move straight back, see, if our hands move straight back, it's going to keep our shoulders out in front of us on the swing plane. If we start fanning our club, if we start lifting our club up, okay, if we start getting the toe up too soon, you see how that pulls my shoulders inside? And when my shoulders are pulled inside, they're just going to keep going inside. And then I'm going to have trouble, okay, on the downswing, because I've taken my shoulder unit off the plane. But again, we want to keep the shoulders on plane. So if you have a tile floor that has a straight line on it, a good drill would be, take your club and drag the club on that straight line for as long as you can. Keep the club on the ground. And it's probably going to drag on the ground for about the first 6 inches. And then the club is going to start to lift on the shoulder plane, okay, on the shoulder plane unit. Again, because my trail shoulder is below my lead shoulder, now my club is going to naturally lift, and my club is going to naturally get pulled where? Out on the swing plane. It's not going to get pulled to the inside. The shoulders, because the hands are going straight back, are going to keep the club out in front of me all the way up to the top of my backswing. Instead of being back here, instead of being yanked back here and twisting and swaying, see, instead of twisting and swaying back here, my shoulders are going to stay on the plane. They're going to lift. They're going to stay on the plane. Okay, then they're going to drop right on the plane so my club can do what? So my club can drop from the inside, get back out in front of me, and hit down on the ball. So we just did 3-for-1 right there. As long as we understand what our shoulder unit is doing. Okay, so again, the only way you're going to be able to keep this club head on this line here on your tile floor is if your hands do what? If your hands just move straight back. If you start to lift, if you start to fan open, if you start to get the toe up too soon, this club's going to immediately come off this line, okay, and get too far to the inside. This club has to drag on the ground for at least 6 inches for you to create that space you need, again, to establish the shoulder unit as the swing plane to go up and around your body. Because when we get to parallel, guys, we want the club to do what? We want the club to go straight up. We don't want to get to parallel going to the inside and then getting way back here. And then all of a sudden it pulls our whole body unit off the plane, and then again we have to make up for it. You see, so again, it's important to know again that your shoulder unit makes up your entire swing plane, and we have to honor that, okay, with the positioning of our wrists and our hands, which positions the club head all the way up around the top of our backswing and even on the downswing, so we'll have the clearance to come back down to hit through the ball. Okay, so I hope this helps. Hope this helps. I try to make these videos shorter because, guys, once you understand how the 2-6 leverage grip works, and again, the leverage grip, the 2-6 grip is not a strong grip, it's a leverage grip. And once you understand how the posture works, how the spine-centered posture works, then everything falls into place with your golf swing. Now, for those of you who don't know me, click the first link below in the description box under This Works. Guys, you'll see my swing, you'll see testimonials from other 2-6 golfers from around the country, around the United States, telling you how their swings have changed, how their swings have gotten more simple. Okay, now the second link in the description box below is an option for you to do what? To get more free videos from me here on 2-6, more free videos from me here on Simple Swings. Okay, guys, you'll love it because I try to keep my videos on those networks below 3 minutes. Again, once you understand the grip and the posture, you don't need any more than 3 minutes to understand every club position, every body position in the golf swing. Okay, now, if you like this video, click the like button. If you want to subscribe to the channel, please subscribe to the Simple Swing Thoughts YouTube channel so I can usher out more videos, guys, to get this public service announcement out. This whole 2-6 process is a public service to the golf instruction industry. Guys, so you can play better golf, lower your scores, be more consistent, get more distance, okay, and have more fun at golf, okay? Terry here, Simple Swing Thoughts, YouTube Live. Guys, I will talk to you in the next video.